Our next inductee is Alina Johansson from our women's soccer team. She's one of the most decorated players in the history of our women's soccer program. Conference Newcomer of the Year, Player of the Week, All-Conference, All-Region, all those accolades. She picked up almost every one of them. Career leader in points, regular season, single season leader in points and assists, single game records, ranks in the top 10 in career assists, goals, game-winning goals. Great accolades, and I could go on and on about the statistics. But I think Coach Sam said it best, and I since Coach Sam is not coming up here to speak, Chrissy's going to be the presenter. I'm not stealing her thunder. So the quote that Sam said I thought was really good. Our program would not be at the level we are today without EJ and her 4 years of investment. Her mark on the program goes far beyond her playing career. She opened doors for international players to follow in her footsteps and helped ERAU establish itself as one of the top programs in the country. And I think that's true. She was that difference maker, that game changer that helped establish us and get us to that breakthrough, like Abby and her team did for Jocelyn when they first made the final site in Sioux City. You got to break through. And EJ helped us break through, no question about that. One other quote I want to share, and then we'll play the video. This came from one of EJ's teammates. She was a spirited student who thrived on this actually came from one of our professors, I'm sorry. She was a spirited student who thrived on intellectual and leadership challenges, both academically and socially. I would shorten that and say, she was a spirited student, both academically and socially. The soccer team had a really, really fun program, really fun times, and she was a phenomenal player for us, no question about that. So let's play the highlight video for Alina Johansson, and we'll take a look at some of those highlights.
Alina Johansson, or better known by many as EJ, is the perfect embodiment of a student person player. School was always first, with fun after, and being an awesome soccer player just came as the cherry on top. For this and many other reasons, her induction into the Hall of Fame was only a matter of time. When my class came to Embry-Riddle, EJ showed us what's what in Daytona, like good spots on the beach and great places to eat like Taco Bell, not to mention how to get on coach's good side. Joking aside, EJ worked tirelessly to get good grades and be an incredible soccer player while making sure to have a good time and encouraging others to do so as well.
I can't even count how many defenders' ankles she's broken with her insane footwork fluidly dancing around the other team. She brought unique humor to the team that often resulted in us laughing ourselves to tears. EJ embodies the motto, life's a game and soccer is serious. Her intelligence, hard work, and dedication helped blaze the trail for our team's rise to the elite status it remains at today. On top of her unbelievable soccer talent, she also got it done in the classroom. She deserves this honor and belongs in Embry-Riddle's Hall of Fame.
See the champion, we take the field now. Unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets, our heads are lifting. As we lose our inhibition, celebration, it surrounds us. Every nation, all around us, sing forever young. Singing songs underneath the sun. Let's rejoice in the beautiful game. And together at the end of the day, we all say, when I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a wave. And when I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a wave.
Serving as the presenter tonight for Alina Johansson is one of our former players and a great player in her own right is Chrissy Menez.
Two feet and a soccer ball. That's all it took for EJ to make a name for herself. EJ's career was sensational, incredible, phenomenal, and every other synonym in the dictionary. Her all-around soccer skills are absolutely second to none, as is her love for the game, and it showed every time she stepped on that field. Sorry. Honestly, I could stand up here and spit stats at you all night. But as JP showed you, that's just it. It would literally take all night. Let me put it this way. If you open up the record books for women's soccer, it's just CJ's name. Everywhere. I promise you, everywhere. So there's no denying that EJ's an incredible soccer player. But let me share a few things that make her special off the field. EJ's an amazing friend, and she's extremely honest. In fact, last week, she admitted to me that she doesn't actually know how to pronounce my name. Think about that. We've known each other for almost 8 years now, and she doesn't even know how to say my first name. 8 years. And she asked me to marry her to get a green card. Thankfully, I didn't, because I'd be in jail right now. But at least she's honest, right? EJ's always teaching me new things. I'm going to Sweden in a month to play soccer, and thanks to her, I feel like I have a real head start on the language. Now, she never actually taught me how to say, my name is Chrissy, but I can say every cuss word that you can think of. I've also witnessed her weird obsession with Swedish meatballs, so it won't be as much of a culture shock when I get there. Unless that's just an EJ thing, which it very well could be. EJ's one of the funniest, most animated people I've ever met. At Publix, she used to make me sit in the child seat of the cart and would leave me in random aisles. And she would go and tell other customers that I was lost. Of course, I can't get out of the cart by myself, so I'm kind of just sitting there completely helpless. And then there was that one time she put me up for adoption, to which we received several responses of taking me in. Thank you, Schultz family. My point is, there's no such thing as a dull moment with E. You can ask anyone that's ever had the pleasure of spending time with her, and I guarantee they'll have an epic story up their sleeve. 2 feet and a soccer ball, and now a place in Eagle Athletics history. Players like EJ don't come around often, and people like EJ are even more rare. In all seriousness, I couldn't ask for a better friend or teammate. She truly is one of the best to ever rep the blue and gold. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Elina Johansson.
Thanks, Chrissy. You're all lost on the marriage. I said, oh wow, I can't come up here now after that introduction, but I'm a good person, I promise. Wow, what an honor to be here tonight. I know some former teammates who deserve this equally as much, if not more. So I definitely share this with them. And it's still hard to believe I'm part of the 2017 Hall of Fame with these amazing people and athletes. Congrats to all of you. I'm going to be honest, we don't really have Hall of Fame in Sweden, and I've never been to Hall of Fame gala before. So for my speech, I thought I could just say some thanks and that'll be it, and just walk off. But I went on YouTube to see how other people said things, and I saw that all the videos were 15 to 30 minutes long. So I froze, died a little, and tried to get out of this. But both coach and my mom told me, no, you have to go. This is just once in a lifetime. And yeah, so here I am. But yeah, the first video that popped up on YouTube was Michael Jordan's Hall of Fame speech. And I figured I could use his words, since nothing he's ever done is wrong, right? So started writing down what he said, and then he started thanking all these basketball people, and I figured it'd be really weird if I thanked them. So so what I'm about to say is 100% EJ, and not Michael Jordan, just so you know. First, I would like to thank the university for giving me the opportunity to come here and play and study, despite my awesome TOEFL score. Thank you, Coach Ritter. But yeah, 10 years ago, I was a member of Damn, Chrissy, you're so short. But 10 years ago, I was a member of the under-19 national team back in Sweden. I was playing with and against some of the best players in the world, and I was told I had a great career ahead of me with that if I just kept working hard, I was going to play in both the Olympics and the World Cup. But I had a couple of friends who were playing college soccer here in Florida, and I remember them coming home for summer, super tanned, and saying how great it is to play soccer overseas. They practice once a day and school was easy. And I thought, great, it sounds like paradise. So after a lot of thinking, I came to the conclusion that I wanted to play for fun in Florida and get a degree at the same time. I mean, what is the World Cup compared to bus ride down to Miami on a bus with a broken AC? Or as a freshman, sharing the bed with a teammate who had a nightmare and wet the bed. Team bonding as its finest. But little did I know that the Embry-Riddle women's soccer team I joined in 2007 was going to become family, and the playing for fun was going to be playing for and with your best friends. Giving it all on the field, playing through pain and spending several hours in the training room taking care of injuries. This whole practice once a day, super chill, didn't really apply to Embry-Riddle. I can easily say I ran more the first day of preseason than I ever done in my entire career. Thanks, coach. I mean it though. I know I wouldn't be up here if I had a different coach. You made soccer fun again, even though we didn't really win all the time. You pushed me to succeed both on and off the field. Not so much Russell's. We blamed it on the assistant coaches. I'm sorry for all the gray hairs, coach. Not that you have any. I mean, yeah, you know what I mean. I'm going to stop here. But thanks, coach, for everything. I think you should be awarded with the Coaches Hall of Fame for putting the Embry-Riddle women's soccer team on the map. I've also had some great professors during my time here who always went the extra mile to help me understand and answer my stupid questions. I will never forget coming to class one day it was a successful weekend of playing games. And this was my speech class with one of my favorite professors, Dr. Cunningham. He gave me a hat, congratulating me on my hat trick. And I still have this hat today, and getting this from a professor meant so much to me, especially since I was more talented at soccer than in school. Yes, I admit that, and I think the professors agree. But I met so many great people during my time here, and who also helped me winning this award. I would like to thank all of my former teammates, and especially my kiddos, who flew in from all over the country to be here tonight, and to my amazing mom, who came all the way from Sweden. I know you're jet-lagged and tired, just try to stay wakeful a bit more. Last but not least, my absolutely amazing American parents. I think most of you know who you are, and I definitely share this award with you. I can't thank you enough for what you've done for me, and not just supporting me, but the whole team, and making us, especially internationals, feel like we have a home away from home. You guys are the best. And I wouldn't trade my 4 years here at Embry-Riddle for anything, and I'm so grateful to have played in blue and gold. With that, I would just like to thank all of you, and once an eagle, always an eagle. See you at Ocean Deck.
You know, EJ was saying how she was a much better player than she was a student, but she was a pretty darn good student. It's just the fact that she was a really, really good player. I think she graduated with like a 3.3 GPA, so don't believe that she wasn't a very good student. And although that TOEFL score wasn't very good, we'll give you credit for that. TOEFL scored not a true test of being able to speak English and speak and be successful at every riddle. I think she proved that, and so have several others. So congratulations again, and glad you made the trip all the way back here from Sweden. So great to see you. We're moving on to the sport of baseball, and Philip Remy is up next. So he's the third player from the baseball team to go into the Hall of Fame, and the story behind the story is a great one. But I'm going to leave most of that for Dave Thurneau to tell you. So what I will tell you is the phenomenal two seasons he had for us as a relief pitcher. During his senior year, 15 saves, single season record for Embry-Riddle all time. But his junior year was unbelievable. Gave up, those of you that follow baseball, this will make sense. He gave up one run that year, not in one game, that year. And he didn't give up a run until the World Series, when he had to come on in relief and pitch out of the bullpen for six innings. Not what usually a closer does, comes in and pitches one inning sometime, but unbelievable season. Also an excellent student. He was an NAIA scholar athlete, academic all-conference, earned his bachelor's degree in air traffic control, and stuck around and helped coach and got a master's degree in aeronautics here from Embry-Riddle. And the quote here is, "The motto of the athletic department is the student person player. Philip nailed all three. He was not only one of the best players, but also a leader on the team the entire time he was here." And I think this quote came from Randy Stiegel. "I once polled the team and asked them, if you were stuck in Iraq, pinned down by terrorists, who would you want by your side? And every member of the team wrote down Philip Remy's name." So he's the guy that you want in your foxhole with you. And he was a phenomenal player during his time here at Embry-Riddle. So let's look at the video and we'll learn more about Philip Remy. Serving as the presenter tonight for Elina Johansson is one of our former players and a great player in her own right, is Krizzy Menyes.
Two feet and a soccer ball. That's all it took for EJ to make a name for herself. EJ's career was sensational, incredible, phenomenal, and every other synonym in the dictionary. Her all-around soccer skills are absolutely second to none, as is her love for the game, and it showed every time she stepped on that field. Sorry. Honestly, I could stand up here and spit stats at you all night, but as JP showed you, that's just it. It would literally take all night. Let me put it this way. If you open up the record books for women's soccer, it's just EJ's name. Everywhere. I promise you, everywhere. So there's no denying that EJ's an incredible soccer player. But let me share a few things that make her special off the field. EJ's an amazing friend, and she's extremely honest. In fact, last week, she admitted to me that she doesn't actually know how to pronounce my name. Think about that. We've known each other for almost 8 years now, and she doesn't even know how to say my first name. 8 years. And she asked me to marry her to get a green card. Thankfully, I didn't, because I'd be in jail right now. But at least she's honest, right? EJ's always teaching me new things. I'm going to Sweden in a month to play soccer, and thanks to her, I feel like I have a real head start on the language. Now, she never actually taught me how to say, "My name is Krizzy." But I can say every cuss word that you can think of. I've also witnessed her weird obsession with Swedish meatballs, so it won't be as much of a culture shock when I get there. Unless that's just an EJ thing, which it very well could be. EJ's one of the funniest, most animated people I've ever met. At Publix, she used to make me sit in the child seat of the cart and would leave me in random aisles. And she would go and tell other customers that I was lost. Of course, I can't get out of the cart by myself, so I'm kind of just sitting there completely helpless. And then there was that one time she put me up for adoption, to which we received several responses of taking me in. Thank you, Schultz family. My point is, there's no such thing as a dull moment with E. You can ask anyone that's ever had the pleasure of spending time with her, and I guarantee they'll have an epic story up their sleeve. 2 feet and a soccer ball, and now a place in Eagle Athletics history. players like EJ don't come around often, and people like EJ are even more rare. In all seriousness, I couldn't ask for a better friend or teammate. She truly is one of the best to ever rep the blue and gold. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Elina Johansson.
Thanks, Chrissy. You're a loss on the marriage. I said, oh wow, I can't come up here now after that introduction, but I'm a good person, I promise. Wow, what an honor to be here tonight. I know some former teammates who deserve this equally as much, if not more. So I definitely share this with them. And it's still hard to believe I'm part of the 2017 Hall of Fame with these amazing people and athletes. Congrats to all of you. I'm going to be honest, we don't really have Hall of Fame in Sweden, and I've never been to Hall of Fame Gala before. So for my speech, I thought I could just say some thanks and that would be it, and just walk off. But I went on YouTube to see how other people said things, and I saw that all the videos were 15 to 30 minutes long. So I froze, died a little, and tried to get out of this. But both coach and my mom told me, no, you have to go. This is just once in a lifetime. And yeah, so here I am. But yeah, the first video that popped up on YouTube was Michael Jordan's Hall of Fame speech. And I figured I could use his words, since nothing he's ever done is wrong, right? So started writing down what he said, and then he started thanking all these basketball people, and I figured it'd be really weird if I thanked them. So so what I'm about to say is 100% EJ, and not Michael Jordan, just so you know. First, I would like to thank the university for giving me the opportunity to come here and play and study, despite my awesome TOEFL score. Thank you, Coach Ritter. But yeah, 10 years ago, I was a member of... Damn, Chrissy, you're so short. But 10 years ago, I was a member of the under-19 national team back in Sweden. I was playing with and against some of the best players in the world, and I was told I had a great career ahead of me with... that if I just kept working hard, I was going to play in both the Olympics and the World Cup. But I had a couple of friends who were playing college soccer here in Florida, and I remember them coming home for summer, super tanned, and saying how great it is to play soccer overseas. They practiced once a day, and school was easy. And I thought, great, it sounds like paradise. So after a lot of thinking, I came to the conclusion that I wanted to play for fun in Florida and get a degree at the same time. I mean, what is the World Cup compared to bus ride down to Miami on a bus with a broken AC? Or as a freshman, sharing the bed with a teammate who had a nightmare and wet the bed. Team bonding at its finest. But little did I know that the Embry-Riddle women's soccer team I joined in 2007 was going to become family, and the playing for fun was going to be playing for and with your best friends. Giving it all on the field, playing through pain, and spending several hours in the training room taking care of injuries. This whole practice once a day, super chill, didn't really apply to Embry-Riddle. I can easily say I ran more the first day of preseason than I ever done in my entire career. Thanks, coach. I mean it, though. I know I wouldn't be up here if I had a different coach. You made soccer fun again, even though we didn't really win all the time. you pushed me to succeed both on and off the field. Not so much Russell's. We blamed it on the assistant coaches. I'm sorry for all the gray hairs, coach. Not that you have any. I mean, yeah, you know what I mean. I'm going to stop here. But But thanks, Coach, for everything. I think you should be awarded with the Coaches Hall of Fame for putting the Embry-Riddle women's soccer team on the map. I've also had some great professors during my time here who always went the extra mile to help me understand and answer my stupid questions. I will never forget coming to class one day it was a successful weekend of playing games. And this was my speech class with one of my favorite professors, Dr. Cunningham. He gave me a hat, congratulating me on my hat trick. And I still have this hat today, and getting this from a professor meant so much to me, especially since I was more talented at soccer than in school. Yes, I admit that, and I think the professors agree. But I met so many great people during my time here, and who also helped me winning this award. I would like to thank all of my former teammates, and especially my kiddos, who flew in from all over the country to be here tonight, and to my amazing mom, who came all the way from Sweden. I know you're jet-lagged and tired, just try to stay wakeful a bit more. Last but not least, my absolutely amazing American parents. I think most of you know who you are, and I definitely share this award with you. I can't thank you enough for what you've done for me, and not just supporting me, but the whole team, and making us, especially internationals, feel like we have a home away from home. You guys are the best. And I wouldn't trade my 4 years here at Embry-Riddle for anything, and I'm so grateful to have played in blue and gold. With that, I would just like to thank all of you, and once an eagle, always an eagle. See you at Ocean Deck.